Greetings, hello, and welcome back to Summer Crusader Kings 3. Last time, we had a little bit of an issue with our neighbors to the north. Yeah, and now we have to see. Like, I basically was looking around the map just for 10 minutes, and I don't really have a plan right now. It's more a matter of, okay, let's just let time run a bit and see where we go. We still have the option to try to snag this, but I think we checked that the last time already, that if we were to declare war here for the Duchy of East Anglia, it says inferior, but it's like we have 5,000 and it's 4.5. It's too close for comfort, and we don't have any sort of war chest. So let's just let time pass, get some money, get some prestige, get some piety. Hopefully, like, it's kind of close, but it's still like 721 points away at 10 per month, at 70 months, so that's still a few years away. What I will do though, just also to see how that is, adapt special success and let's think on that matter. All of our kingdoms automatically changed to elective. I thought we had to do this for each one separately. Yep, alright. Okay. Well, now we only have to see how that voting works and how we can convince people to vote for the same person. And we have a single heir and don't split up our realm. So let's see. The Kingdom of Ireland. These are the candidates. That's probably everyone, every male, not even every male, everybody, even my kids. Pretty much my whole dynasty is a possible heir. And these are the electors. I have 5 votes. And you have 1 vote, you have 2, 2, 1, 2, 1. Who are these people in Whiteworth? They have votes. Chieftess of Uftiskefle. Hang on a second, are you telling me the Alba people get a vote? But why? That makes no sense to me. So, and this is then who they're voting for, right, at the moment. So they're either voting for my grandson, my other grandson, or my third grandson. The Earl of Somerset. And these are kids that don't even have any land right now. But I will probably go from here. I was, like, my primary candidate would be the Duke of the Herbenmuth, who should be my Stuart and son. Ooh, you got a little bit roughed up there. Yeah, I was kind of thinking, yeah, having a stewardship focus for the next character would be kind of nice. To, you know, build up the realm a little bit, have more finances. Yeah, let's go with him. Cast my vote. Makes him the new player heir. Right. Now, next thing, Kingdom of England. Various people have various votes. Now, I'm just gonna nominate the same guy here, my same son, for all 3 titles, and then we'll see whether or not the others vote with me or vote against me. There's 32 electors in England. Now this is how much they like my candidate, right? This deep red number. Yeah, he will also vote for me. Thank you. Yikes. And of course, because it's the Kingdom of England, like, everybody and their son and daughter gets a vote here. Like, Smallland, Vestrasia, Alba gets a vote. Can they vote my title to... Oof. I don't know. Was this a good idea? Probably not. Are we stuck with it? Absolutely. Now, and over here, I cast that vote. And he himself should be one of the electors, right? Because, yeah. Excuse me? He's like, no, I don't want to be king. I want my brother to be king. What? Dude, what's wrong with you? Oh, you're humble. Is that why you're not voting for yourself? Let's see. We can probably change our vote. I want to say at any time. Where do I have to go for this? Here, succession, I guess. View election. Yeah. Alright, let's just see how this goes. Anything else? Yeah, sure. Negotiate alliance. I never modified the contracts with my grandsons, who own the duchies down there. Let's actually do that. Let's also change that to high levies. Use the hook. Yeah. Cool. Active legends, yeah, two of your spouses. Do I take care of the marriages here? Who are you then? My handsome grandson. Sure, let's see if we can find you a nice, nice someone. Oh, my granddaughter. No, let's not keep it in the family this time, though. I could also check for alliances. By the way, can I not just say here then in the filters, dynasty, not my own. That certainly works. She's 33, but she's a genius. How old are you? 17. No, let's not. Let's go with a reasonable age difference. Oh, that trims it down. Yeah, let's get you betrothed to her. My granddaughter, 30 years old. Let's totally reset the filters and sort totally by alliance power. Do we even get an alliance because she's my granddaughter, High Chiefdom of Moray? Isn't that inside Scotland? That's an interesting constellation. If that gets me an alliance with 2,000 men, yeah, sure. The kids will not be of my dynasty. I don't think I can, yeah, matrilineally marry that, but at some point that's gotta be. Okay, and I have another granddaughter. You are 17. You're a genius. You know what? In your case, I'd like to keep them in our family, though. not that much in our family. Everybody's my own family here. Yeah, let's just hear some random guy, another nice inheritable trait. Sure, get him over here. I could have probably checked for someone with high combat skills so that I get additional knights in my realm. Okay, you have converted something. Keep converting, please. You're training commanders, that's good. What are you doing? I feel like the active one could be a little bit more high. I think he's collecting taxes, right? Do we want to promote culture? I do remember we converted that down here. I'm not sure how much of a difference the culture is. Now it does have an impact on our research speed. Like the culture research speed is dependent on the average development of all the provinces of this culture. I don't think we've talked about development much, but it's basically like an indicator of how well developed the country is. And the thing is, Ireland kind of sucks for development. Like, my capital has 2. The problem is also that as a tribal, development doesn't really do that much. But if we ever want to get out of tribal, we need development 5 in our capital, so why don't we actually do that a little bit? I like how there's only positive side effects, not negative side effects. Interesting. Alright, carry on. Let's go speed 4. Marvelous news. Do we call a hunt? Spend all our money on that? I don't think so. Hang on, that's a new one. Because I'm a wise man, I have this mystical communion now, giving me some lifestyle XP, a boost to stress, and there may be unforeseen side effects. What's the worst? Oh, it costs me. Well, piety is fine, as long as it doesn't cost me devotion. Also, now we do have my cursed court physician here, who never got any better. Alright, one last check. Got prisoners. I don't think I care about anyone here, so let's just ransom that. Oh, my daughter wants to join me in my when I'm having a little smoke here. So this one looks kind of nice. So +2 knowledge per level of devotion. We're currently sitting at 26 knowledge. Take it, unlock it, bam, +8, 34. That's a nice boost. % of counselor's primary skills added to your own. Yeah, we'll see how much we get. I don't think changing anything around and trying to get into another tree makes that much of a difference at this stage. Oh, look, we got one ducat for one of the prisoners. Awesome. Don't spend it all at once. By the way, what's happening here? You're raiders. You're fighting. Alba is at peace. Okay. Smallland is at peace, but something is being sieged there. Okay. Let's keep an eye out on these raiders. If they come, we want to intervene. By the way, I was looking around here earlier, and I saw that this here, they are at war. They are defending against the High Queen of Ireland. It's like, what? Yeah, my wife, who owns Leinster, attacked that. So, good luck on that. Yeah, I can still call a hunt, or I can host a feast. Again, I'm just gonna dismiss those for now. Do we go for speed 5? Oh, that was my marshal, right? Yeah. So, time to find someone for that position. He's been a marshal for a long, long time. Ah, okay. I was like, shouldn't that be sorted by marshal skill? But it's probably also has my powerful vassals who kind of expect a position on the council up top. But screw that guy, he likes me anyway, he likes me anyway. I'd rather have someone with a high martial skill. And I'm even tempted. So she is 18, right? But she's also 52 years old. Like, she's not gonna be Schlange. Reduced monthly income. Does that mean you cost me less? Was thinking maybe I just take a younger boy here, this guy, and he might still level up his skill over time. Holy Warrior Reaver. Yeah, let's take him. Congratulations. Train the commanders. All good. Kind of waiting for this war to resolve to see where we're standing at that point. How can a heart endure this kind of pain without breaking? It cannot be possible yet here. My heart beating on what's yours has gone quiet. Oh, my sunshine. Life will not be the same without you. My wife, my friend, my pilgrim has died. So we're looking at now. I think technically we should get another wife just to keep the piety high. It feels so weird at 68. Oh, let's marry again. I mean, first of all, oh no, the sorrow overcomes me. Yet another wife's dead. The one with the good stats. I will drown my sorrow in the arms of someone new. Alright, doesn't look like I can get an alliance with anyone. What about, can I get prestige from anything? Yeah. Is it even sorting here? Why does it say 31 out of 50? So it wasn't showing me anything, anyone around my age, simply because I had the filter in for fertile. Where's that then? Claim on the Earldom of Middlesex. Well then. Yeah. There we go. Oh, by the way, the our neighbor, King Halfred, has won against the Alban Conquest on the Earldom of Derby. Wait, that was here. Okay, but I didn't get any notification for this war ending, but this is now Ireland up here. How are your alliances looking? You lost the alliance with Scully. Huh. And you are in a war against Östergötland. Which looks a little bit one-sided, but okay. Yeah, still, this kind of guy is still in there. So, but you would be a shame if you were distracted with that war and someone were to attack you, right? Oh, I don't want East Anglia, actually, I want Essex. Technically, I want both. I guess I could, in theory, make it a holy war for the Kingdom of England, and then I get all of that territory. He's inferior. Like, it's the holy war problem, where it always says, you know what? In a holy war, if the attacker's faith is pluralist or the defender has vessels, if in the targeted area, some or all vessel rulers in the targeted area may simply be transferred to the attacker instead. Rulers of the same faith as the target may choose to join in their defense without the need of the alliance. So what I'm really interested is, you are probably a Satrol. Which, I mean, I don't know. Can we take that? I mean, of course we cannot take all of that, but will they even join? Are they in their own little wars? Everyone is fighting somewhere. Ah, it's fine. Let's just take it all. What's the worst that could happen? No, don't say that. Yeah, holy war for the Kingdom of England. If we win, we gain some devotion, which is nice. And yeah. Oh, interesting. So if we win, then all the guys become my vassals, so I don't gain this territory. If I were to do the conquest thing, then I will seize all the territory to myself. Now I'm not so sure anymore if I want to do Holy War. Ah, what the hell? Whatever. Double check. It's England. Yes. Declare. Speed 3. Call everyone to call house member to war. Fantastic. We want to ready. The music always when you declare war. There we go. Raise all here. 15 days. Alright. What's that? Betrothed can marry. Absolutely. You're joining my war. You're joining my war. Okay. Let me actually quickly, when I see that, go into my realm, my vassals. And this dude gets sweet, please. Now, before I start losing all my supplies again, I'm gonna split you guys in half. Eventually, I'm gonna remember the keyboard shortcut or the mouse shortcut I need to press here and split them up a little bit. So that they can bang on their shields in separate areas. Gotta keep an eye on for enemy troops, but he's busy with his own war. I think we might be able to maybe quickly siege that all out. I should also keep an eye on my own territory. It's fine. I think it's really hard sometimes to keep an eye on everything. I guess I still see troops even if I'm zoomed out this far. Greetings. I'm serving as your steward. I've learned much about record keeping finance. You're my son, yeah. Willing to tutor you in these topics in order to gain your favor. 50% chance I can increase my stewardship by 2. And 50% chance that I gain temporary stewardship by 3 for 5 years, which is like... Mm-hmm. Okay, what if I help you instead? I could increase his diplomacy. Diplomacy. Or I could say we could both... gain something from that. Or I can just turn him to sort of and gain some prestige. Now let's go with this one. Okay, I increased my stewardship by 2. I think he increased his diplomacy. Yeah, so the downside of zooming out, now I see all the troop movement, but I no longer see my siege progress. So it's 6 of one, half a dozen or the other. I don't know. Also, what's happening here? Is that just because I have the war selected, or is Moray? No, it's still in Alba. Not sure why it's showing up separately right now. Come on, complete the sieges. Mind me, just sneaking up on you guys. Now, in European Evasanis, there's something when you attack someone who's sieging, you can basically take over their siege progress. I'm not sure. The bar is still there, because that can really, really help. What's happening here? Okay. We won this siege. Let's get you guys. Probably over there. Yes, we took over siege progress. That's fantastic. And we took someone prisoner who's not worth war score. And who's gonna be ransomed for 2 ducats. I think if we wait a little bit longer and hope that he actually gains a little bit more money, well, he's not gaining any income. Let's just get you out of my prison. You're just eating my bread here. You can no longer convert the faith. Guess it flipped by itself. Yes, it did. Ah, look at here. 94 men coming straight at me. You can actually... move here, move there, go there, move there. Capture someone else who's not worth war score, same thing. That's will not accept. He's greedy. Concerned for my current war, my friend Kanan has paid out his own treasury to aid in the efforts. 75 monies. You're my friend. I don't even remember who you are. Thank you. I like some monies. And the next task aborted. I think everything is flipping by itself here. That's flipping awesome. Yeah, continue over there. No, didn't do it. Any enemy troops? No, no. Okay. Casual speed 4 then. Not gonna go speed 5 in a war. That's not like speed 5 with my Boomer APM, that's not gonna be good. My allies just decided randomly to, you know what, there are no enemies nearby, let's just stop sieging down here this place. Because there was 900 raiders coming and we only had 4,000 troops. He's not swayed. Which insular populists targeting me? Invite champions. Always invite champions. And one more time, we got a prisoner, not worth any war score. Everyone's greedy here. Could be it's just the same dude as before, but yeah. Why am I commander? What in the world? Who in your... Are you out of your mind? I might actually do some of these stuff, because we have a little bit of money there. Can I not set myself to not command troops somewhere? Like, I don't show up myself here in the champion's top, right? I know there's some place where you can set yourself to not. Is this you? Yeah. I don't know. Alright. Lost a small land conquest of Stargotland. Oh, small land lost their war over there. Well, that's unfortunate for them. So they're used to this whole losing wars thing already, right? So let them lose another war. That looks much better. I think that evens out the power between me and Alba a little bit. Okay, you know what, I'm gonna probably need all that money to create various titles. Okay, stand down the army. Are you still my prisoner? Yes. But you're actually paying 10. Fantastic. I don't wanna usurp, I wanna just create. You will pay me 50, that's nice. My grandson can marry. I'm just gonna, I have so many grandchildren kids. Yeah, marry that girl. I know about that. I just did that. I should have placed my troops here to discourage those raiders. So, I did a control click here, this way I immediately move and don't wait for the full army to fall. Which, I hope doesn't come to bite me in the butt, but we are numbering them 2-1. And so we even gained the loot from the raiders. So yeah. Get out of here. Victory ransom. Okay. Champions. Let's quickly see who arrived. 12, yeah, recruit you for free. 10 ducats and a 9 combat skill. Yeah, you can just stay my guest. So, I think we're still 2 earldoms short. No, we created this. Yeah, the chief wicker. So it's really about the Jarlim of Essex. We could usurp that for 250 and just be done with that. I'm not sure what determines when eventually it will like default back to me, because he shouldn't have that, right? He has no territory in this area, but I don't know rules for that. I'm just gonna usurp that. Now, Need to sort out a little bit of stuff. This guy here. Because this is part of East Anglia, I should probably transfer over here. Grant you the vassal of this guy. No, it should be whoever has Cambridgeshire. Oh, I see the problem. So he has both of these. Yeah, but he really doesn't like me. So yeah. Grant that vessel ship, and then the dukeship of all of this can go to, I guess, whoever likes me the most. Yikes, that's gonna be not much of a contest here. You all kinda hate me. I think probably mostly because short range rival, too many duchies, yeah. Jura duchy, foreign culture. Any one of you guys like not a such renoirs? No. As weird as it sounds, I think I go with someone who at least likes me a little bit. Paranoid sadistic. Yeah, minus 72, that's great. Basically almost best buddies here. Yeah. Grand titles. The High Chiefdom of Essex. Nice. This way all the guys here that were in there who hated me no longer hate me. First of all, no longer hate me that much, but also I don't care that they hate me, because they report to him, and he actually sort of kind of likes me a little bit, almost. Oh boy, I can feel it in my very bones. I feel it in my fingers, I feel it in my bones. Death will come for me soon, like an old friend. He's patiently waiting to receive me. We'll be dead within a year. You should get your affairs in order. Well, that's yeah, I know that. There's some war happening there internally, that's always great. Well, before we do anything else, let's have a quick look with my little voting situation here. What the elections are currently looking like. So there, he seems to be rank 1. Total score of this candidate is 6. Okay, if I sort it by rank, then I see who's voting or who's receiving the most vote. Okay, so Kingdom of Ireland, sorted. Kingdom of Wales, sorted. Even though I'm the only one voting for him. Like, why are you not even voting for yourself? No, actually, he's not in line for succession. Why? Why would you do that? I wish it would show here who's currently winning and not who I'm voting for. So that's not good. And in England, He's rank 4. Huh, okay. With 16 votes for my grandson. Now, what if I were to change my vote to him, who's currently en route to get the Kingdom of England? Well done. Are you anywhere here? Well, I think for Ireland, I can pretty much control the vote, right? I really like how I actually have to select rank manually every freaking time myself. Like, no, no. I want to select that. Why do you change it back? So he's currently rank 3, so yeah, I can swing that vote, make him the primary heir. Kingdom of Wales, rank please. Well, he's not even showing up anywhere on the list. Can I see why you don't like my candidate? Family concerns, minus 50. He's evil, minus 25. What do you mean he's evil? Dishonorable fool. Flagellant. Why are you evil? Deceitful, impatient. So, you know what? I think I'm gonna make a cut in here. And I'm gonna play around with... I think I can, like, change my vote at any point, right? So I can play around a little bit. I would prefer playing as one of my sons, but honestly, if I see this election with currently my grandson at the top, and he's 16 years old, like, if we switch to playing him, we basically have a 16-year-old have a long, long character lifespan that we can play through. He's unlanded. A trickster, so intrigue focused. Intelligent with one wife, and we can get a few others down the line. Probably look, maybe I'll go for him. Maybe I'll spend a little bit more time going through the possible candidates, see who we have in our family. We have the big choice. Let's see who we end up with. It's kind of interesting, both your parents are dead. Slain in battle. Oh, you're also, your grandson is a son of my, my daughter's, not one of my sons. Also interesting that we don't have the like a paternal line, but more a maternal line there that we would be following. We'll see. I'll play around. You'll see the results in the next episode. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.